And if you don't
see the one that's flirting,
I will personally.
I'm not sticking up for Mabel because Mabel said things wrong. She's admitted she said things wrong. She's admitted that she said things wrong. So, but what I'm saying is, please don't quote someone like Feisty, because Feisty has done her own wrong. Feisty's not someone that you can have in your corner. So, guys, I don't want hate in. If you want to come back in, come back in, but don't speak over each other. Angie, I'm just asking you, can we let this go now? Like, if you think Mabel is unstable and unwell and you feel sorry for her, then why are you reacting to her? Why are you trying to put that woman down even more if you believe she's unwell? And if you, I just think, stop talking about each other. Mabel, you need to stop talking about Angie. Everybody needs to leave Angie to do her own thing. But please don't quote people like Feisty, because as far as I'm concerned, Feisty is a wrong one. And I'll say it in front of 2,000 people. Don't quote Feisty, because Feisty's, yeah. Yeah, so Angie, if you want to come back in, request the box, please. And then Mabel can come back in. But this is ridiculous now. We are grown adults. This is absolutely fucking ridiculous. No, Feisty isn't a wrong'un. Okay, she isn't. Okay, my opinion is that Feisty's not a good example for anybody. I'm going to let people in one at a time. Angie, if you want to come back in, you can come back in.
Luke, really quickly before it starts going chaos, I think you're exactly right. I think there's been so much said on both sides, and both sides will always think that the other side has said stuff wrong, that it's offensive to everyone else, because that's always the case. And the amount of stuff that's gone on for this last 3 months or 2 months about this situation is going to continuously go on. And the problem is, you're never going to get an avid solution for this. The only thing that's going to happen is if they both just, even if each other talk about each other, is just to ignore it. To do that, people are always going to try and fight and back their own corner, which I get, but it's never going to come up to a solution. I remember when the Alex Andrew thing started, we were sat in AE Live and we said, let's just leave it, no one talk about each other. Within 30 minutes, no word of a lie, it had all gone on. That was about the 14th different agreement that had happened between these two sides. But since then, the amount of things that have been said have just been crazy, absolutely madness. And I just think you're dead right on this. It's never going to come up to an avid solution. They've just got to ignore each other despite what's being said. Sometimes you've always got a right to reply. I get that, but you've also got a right to cross the road. But you also look left and right to see what's happening around it. So I think you've just got, each side is just, there's too much. You've just got to let it go now.
So who,
because
who
this is not doing anybody any favours, are they?
Who draws the line then, until someone actually one day does get hurt? Who draws this line then? Because it is causing a lot of people stress. The whole Alex and Angie thing, how long, my head nearly blew up, do you know what I mean? Because I was to the point where I deleted TikTok for like 3 days because I was sick of it. I was sick of it.
Yeah.
So,
I'm sorry to interrupt you, Luke. I actually think the answer to that lies within the viewers.
Viewers have to draw the line. The viewers have to draw the line, because when there's that much trauma and shit that's been said either side, TJ's completely right. The viewers have to sit there and make that conscious decision. Do you know what? We've had enough. We don't want to watch this shit show. Because while it carries on and the viewers keep going in, it's going to keep the encouragement going.
Who's that? Tam, are you sure you're allowed to talk about things?
Well, I was hoping to get in here while the boxes were quiet, because I've been watching on the outside and I just wanted 5 minutes.
All right. Do you want everybody?
No,
do you want
the
everybody?
Outside,
do you want everybody to
there
go,
is...
Tam? I'm just going to kick everyone out apart from Tam.
No, it's fine, as long as you don't let the other people in. around one particular person, but I mean, if the other one comes in, there's not really a lot I can do about it. There's no place where to answer where she's concerned.
She's not going
to
come in.
So, Luke, I just wanted to say that, like, I know I'm holding responsibility here, so please don't come for me and start your bullshit. But I've obviously been away from TikTok for the last, well, since everyone knows why I'm away from TikTok, it's obvious, yeah?
Yeah.
And since then, all right, the first week, apart from a select couple of people, which I'm not allowed to talk about or name, like, everyone has left me alone. But the first week, obviously, everyone was talking about it and the harassment was continuing. The problem with this whole situation is how low the other side choose to go. And they, and the one thing that always really upsets the rest of us, which is why we always respond the way that we do, is they always use our family members. They're always using the deaf or the loved ones. They're always using our personal details. And then when you do it back to them, they cry. And that is exactly what happened in my situation. And they were bringing it to my real life. And now it's extended into my real life. And nobody seems to see what the problem is with that. Like, there was two wrongs done, both on my side and on their side, and yet only one person out of a whole group of people has been held accountable, i.e. me. And that's hard, I wasn't even involved in the start of it. This is what's so upsetting about it. And in comparison to everybody else's lives, I've not really joined in on the bandwagon until people started mentioning social services, making those phone calls social services, encouraging those phone calls social services, and then using my children. And then obviously everybody knows what happened after that. Now, you're right, I'm not supposed to be here talking about certain people, which is why they've not been named. But knowing that unstable Mabel has gone through what she's gone through because of me and because of, you know, Pat when she didn't have to, nobody deserves. Look, she came off the app like she said, and then she's come back on the app, and the first thing that she's seen, my children getting attacked, Pat's family members getting used, Maz's kids being used. Like, and yeah, anyone that suffers trauma, it's going to trigger them. And my biggest problem is exactly that. When I see people attacking my friends or people that I care about and using their family or their children, I do things and say things that aren't acceptable. And that's what's happened. So, you know, at the end of the day, nobody should be able ever to use someone's actual abuse and laugh about it and get away with it. And this is what